Yeah. Go down in the comment section. Tell me, what do you think? Do you think they will actually pull the trigger on Seth Rollins messing up this year's WrestleMania by betraying Cody Rhodes to prevent him from finishing the story? All right, folks, WWE has thrown us yet another curveball in the form of Seth Rollins letting Cody Rhodes know that I got your back, bruh. I'm going to shield you away from The Rock, Roman Reigns, the Bloodline, so forth and so on. Basically, this man just said, I got your back. And if we know anything about wrestling, you guys, we know about betrayal. And the architect of betrayal was one Seth Rollins. Yes, we all remember this. We all remember this right here when he took the chair and slapped Roman Reigns in the back. And Dean Ambrose looked at his brother like, what the hell are you doing? And it came out of nowhere, people. See, we was looking on that stage at the press conference and we were clowning Seth. We were saying, Seth, no one even paying attention to Seth. Why is he up there? And Seth has been saying the same thing since winning that world championship. He's been telling people that this championship is the championship. And why would Seth want to betray Cody Rhodes? Why would he want? Why? He just beat him 3 times. That's it. I mean, the man beat him with a pectoral muscle gone and bruised up. So at the end of the day, he has to think to himself, I've been down for this championship since I got it. I've been representing this championship since I got it. And no one has given me any respect for this. I broke my back. I broke my leg. I broke everything defending this championship. But no one is thinking about me. No one is talking about my match at WrestleMania. Everybody's talking about Cody Rhodes. And on top of that, he still didn't pick me, the workhorse champion. So we land on Monday Night Raw this past Monday. And Seth is telling Cody, I created Roman Reigns. I did this in the Shield. I did this. I created this man. I created this monster. You do need to finish your story. And I want to help you finish your story. And I hope that WWE don't pull that. I'm not a fan of Seth Rollins fucking up Cody Rhodes finishing his story. I think, you know, he probably will be the most hated wrestler to ever live. He wouldn't be able to get his status back as being the guy. You know what I mean? Or being a good guy or whatever, you know. You know how long he had to come back from hitting Roman Reigns in the back? Wow. You know, like, for real. Like, that right there took a long time to get us back on his side. Now, if you mess up something that's damn near 3 years in the making, bruh, we had to wait, and then we had to get WWE to change trajectory with We Won Cody because they really thought The Rock was just going to come and everything was going to be everything. But nah, the work that was put in to get Cody on that stage at WrestleMania night 2 against the Tribal Chief Roman Reigns and to be successful, the work that was done to get him there, and you just going to swerve us like that and have Seth fuck it up? Seth Rollins fuck it up? Like, we gave up The Rock. We booed The Rock for this. Woo. I hope they don't do that. You guys, go down in the comments section and tell me what you think. Where is this going? Are they just putting out a little red herring to keep us thinking that Cody is not going to win this thing? I mean, look, I like what they're doing. It's entertaining, and it got my, you know, juices flowing and percolating like, whoa, yeah. Go down in the comments section. Tell me, what do you think? Do you think they will actually pull the trigger on Seth Rollins messing up this year's WrestleMania by betraying Cody Rhodes to prevent him from finishing the story? Yeah, stay inside the storyline. That's all I got. I will catch you down the road. Peace. Y'all be safe.